In a previous video, we talked about vertical asymptotes. Now we're going to talk about horizontal asymptotes. So the question is, if somebody gives you a horizontal line, and every horizontal line is y equals k, how can that be an asymptote of the graph of f of x, the graph y equals f of x? So there's our asymptote, and the question is, what could the graph be doing? And the point is, an asymptote is a curve that is a line that a curve approaches. So you might have the curve approaching like that, or you might have the curve approaching like that, or the curve could even wiggle. But the key feature is that if it's going to be approach at this end, then whenever x is very, very large, f of x has to be very, very close to k. We could also have it approaching on this end, or on this end, or like that. But that means that whenever x is very negative, f of x is very close to k. So the two situations where you have a horizontal asymptote is either the function gets close to k whenever x is large and positive, and the way we'd write that is we say that the limit as x goes to infinity of f of x is k, or the function is very close to k whenever x is large and negative, in which case we write that the limit as x goes to minus infinity of f of x is k. Now remember, infinity and minus infinity are not numbers. Infinity just means without end. It means as you go off to the right, farther and farther and farther and farther and farther, you get closer and closer and closer to k. Or as you go out to the left, farther and farther and farther, you get closer and closer and closer to k. Okay. So here's the mathematical statement. If the limit is k as x goes to infinity, or if the limit as x goes to minus infinity is k, then we have a horizontal asymptote. And a simple example is the function 1 over x. If x is a big positive number, then 1 over x is very close to 0. And if x is a big negative number, 1 over x is also close to 0. So we have a horizontal asymptote at x equals 0. You don't see it because it's hidden by the x-axis, but the curve gets closer and closer and closer to this horizontal line here, and at the other end, it gets closer and closer and closer to this horizontal line. The horizontal line is at x equals 0. Okay. Now, in this case, we have the same line being an asymptote on the right and on the left. That doesn't always happen. If you look at the function arctangent of x, then the arctangent of a very, very large number, an angle whose tangent is a million, is almost 90 degrees. So the limit on the right is pi over 2. But an angle whose tangent is negative a million is almost minus 90 degrees. So this is a function that has two horizontal asymptotes, one at pi over 2, which describes what's happening as x goes to infinity, and one at minus pi over 2, which describes what happens when x goes to minus infinity. And if you don't like inverse trig functions, and most people don't, here's an algebraic example of the same kind of behavior. If you look at the function x over the square root of x squared plus 1, if you plug in a big number, like say 1,000, you get 1,000 over the square root of 1,000,001. And the square root of 1,000,001 is really close to 1,000. So you get a number divided by a number that's slightly bigger than it, and that's really close to 1. But if you plug in negative 1,000, you get negative 1,000 over the square root of 1,000,001. That's close to negative 1. So the curve looks like this. It has an asymptote at y equals 1, where it approaches on the right, and it has a horizontal asymptote at y equals negative 1, that it approaches as x goes to minus infinity.